Where you are is where you got to be committed to, and you got to grow from there. You can't ever get to a point where you feel like you're done, you're complete, it's finished. I don't care who you are, what you're doing. You just cannot think that way up. It may get difficult. It may not be the way you want it. All right? But you can't stop. All right? It's a lot of examples. The more and more we're here as a group and as a coaching staff, and we're going to see things happen that's baffling to other people. All right? But it should no longer be baffling to us. All right? When somebody don't get a lot of reps, but somebody come in and say, hey, man, we got to have this kid because this kid going to make us better. All right? Or you don't play the amount of time that you think you should play, all right, and then your opportunity to get better for you down the road. Okay? You got to continue to develop. I said that here before. I'm going to say it again. Every time you're here or every day that you're here, try to find a way to get better. Now, I can say this, and I'll say this to y'all, be very candid, very honest, very open, transparent. See right through Coach Johnson. There are days when I come in this building, I'm frustrated because there's no growth for coaches. Right? Coaches, you a coach, and that's all they expect you to be. That's it. All right? And that's not good. That's not good for me. I'm not going to speak for anybody else, but for me, that's not good. Like, there's more I like to do. There's more I want to do. All right? But not in always in this building do I feel like that's capable. So sometimes I had to pump my brakes, and I got to remember what I'm here to do. Right? What I want to do is my feelings, but what I'm here to do is my reality. Everybody understand what I just said?
Yes, sir.
All right? So what you feel like you want to do and what you're here to do is two different things. All right? So I always have to curb myself and say, slow down. You're here to do something. You're here to do something different than what everybody else is doing. My friend just came. Justin is a friend of mine, Mr. Blackwell. Introduce him to Gavin, introduce him to the coaches, introduce him to Kerry. Kerry came. All right. Mr. Blackwell worked for the government. Introduced the coach then. Worked for the government. The travel. Took his family. Bangkok, Thailand, Japan. He done lived all over the world. All right? Make a ton of money. Okay? Now, bought a house in Northern Virginia. He's back here for a little bit. I'm going to let him come talk to you. Now, he's an engineer. Okay? A mechanical engineer. I can't tell you what he really, really does, but he do some stuff, okay? Some pretty cool stuff, all right? But this is what I learned from Mr. Blackwell. He just said to me just now. I told him, I said, hey, man, I love you. Every time you come see me, you make an effort to come see me, I appreciate it. It changes my day. And he said, hey, man, every time I see you and your team, y'all change my day. He said, y'all do more for me than I do for y'all, believe me. And sometimes you don't understand what you're doing, how you're doing it, how you're affecting people, or what's going on, but just do what you do and continue to get better every day. If you continue to get better every day, then people can't stop you. And y'all think I'm talking football? I'm not talking football. I'm just talking life, right? Just continue to get better each and every day. Every time you have an opportunity, just get better. That's one of our quotes. That's part of the quote for the scout report this week. Every time you have an opportunity, get better. In class, get better. In the hallway, get better. Talking to females, get better. Hey, doing your chores around the house, get better. Cutting the grass, get better. Brayden cut the grass the other day. I'm thankful he did it because I didn't have a chance to do it. It looked like some trash, but I'm just thankful he did it. It was patches. Some of it was high, some of it was low. He ain't put a bag on there, so the dead grass on the sidewalk, it got dark on him. He ain't blowed it, you know. Thank you, though. I said thank you, man. Because I was grateful for it. Because I don't have the time to do it right now. Y'all understand where I'm coming from?
Yes, sir.
But every time he does it, he going to do what?
Get
better. Every time you do it, get better. He ain't the best. Don't let him charge you $30 to cut no grass at your house. He's not very good at it right now. But over time, the more he does it, the better he going to get at it. Everybody understand that?
Yes, sir.
All right, so let's take what we did on Friday night, and let's improve as much as we possibly can. Let's get better as much as we possibly can. We have great opportunity to get better over the next couple weeks as we prepare ourselves for the stretch, right? The stretch gonna be the stretch. It's gonna be there. My reps, I ain't get as many reps as I want. I understand that. It's not what we're not talking about how you feel. We talk about what you're here to do, right? Some people see the end at 4 weeks. Ours just get started at 4 weeks. Right or wrong?
Right.
Some people see the end at 4 weeks. Ours get started at 4 weeks. Like, we just getting started. We just getting started. Think about it. People say, oh, man, halfway through the season, that game five. Nope, not us. One-third of the season done. You got two-thirds left. All right? So we got to continue to get better. How can we get better? How can you get better? I tell people all the time, the longer you play, the more coaches that come through here. The longer you play, the more coaches that come through here. You play in November, late November. It's only four schools playing. Early December, it's only two schools playing. They want to see somebody at practice. If it's only two schools playing, one is in the south, one is in the north. We hope this one in the south. Everybody right?
Yes, sir.
Y'all feel me, right?
Yes, sir.
We hope this one in the south. We don't care who in the north. We hope this one is in the south. So the longer you play, the more opportunity you get. Y'all cool with that?
Yes, sir.
Open this camera for. Here we go. Chill no more, and then you can come back and chill. That's what you're saying. You can come back when you're 10 years old. 10 years older, and can't chill no more.
Y'all to work on is when you're getting here and you chopping your steps down, I want y'all to explode out your break. All right? That's what we're not doing right now. We're still coming out of our break slow. So right now, it's about flipping your hips and your head and running. All right? It's exaggerated. You gotta flip your hips and you gotta turn your head and run. Let's go, on you. There you go, there you go, Quan. There you go, that's the way you go, right there. Come on up it, Javion. Come on, run, Kerry. Let's go again. Switch lines, yes, sir. All right, explode. Explode, gotta run. There you go, push out of there. Push out of there. There you go, push out of there. Don't slow down. Push out of there. Explode out of there.
Hey, yo. Up Highland.
That jump still hurt.
Did you soak it? Or did you soak it?
Yeah, I soaked it.
Hey, that's his main toenail. But it was dead and black.
It hurt a little bit.
It was like a car hood, just the whole thing.
You gonna yell something?
Yeah, man. I don't want to push my toe against my foot, because that jump will hurt OD.
Round thumb.
I feel like if you can't play through it,
salt. Jalen. Hey, bro, Angel harder than you. Know what?
They called you Angel again, bro. They said your sister's harder than me. What y'all got on me hitting the pole?
What are you doing, bro? Why you say that?
I got five.
Run me in my five.
DB.
Stop playing with DB. Look, look, look. Cardi C, the boy. Cardi C, baby.
Cardi C. Cardi C, bro.
You don't even know what's up. You don't even know how to boot up DB.
You a linebacker, if anything.
He is a linebacker. Hey,
you a backer, bro. Remember that wreck? He was getting smooth.
I probably can't play.
Josh Roberts was running them over all day.
Straight.
supposed to play flat footed like this?
Yeah, I know, but look, you started leaning back, bro. All right, he stepped on your toes, you going to.
Or if you like take off or
just you got to be on the front five. I'm telling you, bro, you got more control doing that.
I want to learn with so bad, bro.
What, DB?
Yes, bro.
Queen, that guy.
What? I ain't gonna say something.
Hey,
you struggling, struggling.
Come on, Wheezy.
Hey, take that vase off.
Yo,
take that vase off.
He been on the whole time.
Yesterday, he put the vase on.
He's strapped. Next segment. Excuses from Malcolm.
But Quez from Malcolm.
Quez always strap people. He don't get burned. Like, he got burned more. Like not that he got burned too many times.
Wait, was it the one?
Yeah, and that's not normal.
Yeah, one and then I think two and out.
You get burned regularly.
Who burned me other than a slant route?
When Davion Boogie burned
me. Yeah, that's a bad one.
Oh! Davion Boogie burned
me. Who strapped that? How? No.
I'm a DB, but I know what you're saying.
He tried to catch it, I played through it.
I know that, I said that. And Javion was like, no, I had a
easy money, though.
That's what I'm saying. Javion, receivers don't get that point. When you play through the handle.
They just get that somebody might be trying
to. Okay, you might be beat. That's a whole side screen,
bro. This bye week. That shit threw me off, bro.
Mm-hmm.
I just ready to play, bro.
Can't wait till Friday, bro.
Ain't it, bro. I don't care if we playing away or not.
Get back at it.
Ain't it, though, bro.
Put that jersey back on.
We didn't got their 12 back up. Oh my God, Juice! Who's that, Juice?
I don't know.
Hit the gate!
So that nigga Juice hit the gate.
What's up?
Here goes Devon Simmons.
Don't try and blame it on that. Making excuses.
It's Devon.
Watch this, watch this.
Devo.
I can do that. You good? Your glove's good.
I mean, I can do that with my ass clean.
Oh, you know.
Yeah, I'm good. That's one.
He tried to
this is the homemade heaven. Homemade heaven. Pre-rapping tape.
But it's one zip, bro.
It's one. Look at that. That's one Devo. No, stop using this. Come over here. Team, let's get this.
DJ Goodwyn, outside linebacker, class of 2020.
I wanna do it my like.
Is Malcolm asking me the question?
Tavarus Short, class of 2020. I wanna do that.
You're asking me the question.
I'm asking you the question. Yeah. So DJ.
Tavarus Short, class of 2020. Linebacker.
So I'm asking you the question.
Yeah, yeah.
DJ, why do you always go so hard, even when you're supposed to not go hard?
I mean, gotta give 110% all the time. You don't never know when it's the last day of playing football.
But you can make it my last day of playing football when I'm not going hard and you're going hard.
I mean, if you're in the way, you get ran over. That's what happens.
But we're walking through, DJ.
I don't go hard at the walk.
You stepped on my ankle.
No. I got pushed into you.
You gave Jamon a concussion.
You gave Jamon a concussion, right?
Because Jamon should have made the tackle.
DJ is a hard
Jamon has the tackle.
He does it when it's not supposed to be done.
Let me hit that up too, though. Even though I ain't getting no
day. Hey, this the family pack, man?
No, I'm just saying. I forgot.
Tavarus Short, class of 2020. Outside linebacker. That was it.
Why are you such a dog?
I mean, I was born with it. Wasn't nothing to teach. My dad put me in football inside. I wanted to play. That's it.
Yeah, I feel that.
Hey, Kat, come here, bro. Come here, Kat. Come on, man. You know what I'm saying?
You might have to zoom in.
This little Wynell. You know what I'm saying?
Roscoe.
You know what I'm saying? Roscoe. He real funny. Yeah, this is my dog.
Hey, Kyle, what position you play?
Corner. Right.
How long you been playing for Highland Springs?
Well, about 2 years now. I've started my 10th grade year. Okay. I was supposed to play my 9th grade year. But I didn't live in the school zone, so I couldn't find a way back.
What year?
2020.
2020, so you got another year. So what you gonna do next year?
I'm gonna turn up. catch you fixing everything.
Alright. Let me think. What's some personal goals you had this year?
Right now, it was for me just playing. I was coming as a junior, first year on varsity. I just wanted to get in the game. That's all I wanted to do.
Mine too.
I just wanted to get better, period. Like, my goal for like the whole entire year is to at least catch one pick, maybe 10. I want to have at least 5 to 10 tackles. Something like, you know, reasonable for my height and size.
Who's the most serious coach that y'all got?
Coach Austin.
The goofiest one.
In school, on the field, it's just game time. It's straight face with him. There's no, we gotta go.
Ray, we get down to the end of the 9 weeks. Everybody got projects, everybody got tests. If you want to class with somebody that's on this team, y'all need to be studying for the test together and working on the project. Or you need to be reminding your teammate about the project and what's due. Don't wait until the last minute. Oh, I gotta run and do this project, I gotta miss practice. No, you got time all Saturday, all Sunday, to work on that project together. A little bit tonight if you're gonna work on it. At least talk about it, brainstorm, and map out your idea. All right? Hold on. You're dressed for tomorrow. All right? Your best. Whatever your best is. Everybody understand me? What you wore to homecoming, we dressing up. Everybody understand that? Everybody got it. If your best is jeans and a button-up shirt, everybody understand that? And that's your best, that's your honest best, then I'm taking that. Everybody understand? All right, if you want to wear a suit, wear a suit, your best. Everybody understand what I just said?
Yes, sir.
All right? The weather tomorrow is going to be a little chilly. Okay, y'all see how the environment, how the weather changed and the temperature dropped. Everybody understand that? I need no Iron Man. I don't need you to be on wearing no sleeves, no pants. I don't need that. I need you to be ready to play football. Everybody understand? I'm going to share a little something with you. And then I'm going to let you go. Wearing all white, get your uniforms before we go. And we got any questions. Anybody got any questions before I get started? All right. How many of y'all familiar with Lewis and Clark? Y'all been studying the history, right?
Yeah.
Well, what's the significance of Lewis and Clark? Why was that so important?
They went and, like, explored the Louisiana Territory that Thomas Jefferson
built. Louisiana Territory that Thomas Jefferson did what?
He bought.
So they went on the, anybody know how long the voyage was?
Nah.
3 years. So now, they on a 3-year voyage. Everybody understand that? They gotta face who? To get this territory, they gotta face who?
Native Americans.
Indians, right?
Didn't they get a friend
Got Sacagawea. Now, let me tell you something a little history don't tell you. All right, little history don't tell you this. They walked around and they had an air gun. Everybody understand where I'm coming from?
Yes, sir.
To get this air gun to load and to shoot, to manipulate these Indians, right? Because if you're in Indian territory, and somebody come through here, and they just feel like they gonna take our territory, y'all gonna do what? Gonna fight, right? All right, so we gonna take these Indian territory. They got this air gun, specific air gun. You had to pump this air gun 1,500 times for it to shoot 15 times. Everybody understand what I just said? You had to pump it 1,500 times to get 15 shots. So every time they approached some Indians, he walked up to the Indians, and what did he do? He mentioned who he was, mentioned what he was doing, and he went out and demonstrated what his rifle could do. Now, if y'all knew that it was an air gun, and it ain't shoot real bullets, right? You wouldn't be scared. Everybody understand that? But when I pull this gun out, and I start shooting cans from about 200 yards away, and it's rapid fire, and I got all these other guys with me, the Indians start what? They start backing down, start getting scared. So the American story of this is, we took over the Louisiana Territory. The Coach Johnson version of the story is, don't let people play with your mind. Because he manipulated the Indians with an air gun. Y'all hear what I just said?
Yes, sir.
If they would have known it was an air gun, what y'all think the Indians would have did? Had their heads on sticks. But they was fooled by what people was telling them. They understand the magnitude of their strength. So they went out and they just allowed somebody to take their territory because of what they was thinking. They probably sat in their teepees, they got guns. We need to back down because they got guns. Instead of somebody just trying. So people can tell you what they want about who you are. Until you go out and prove who you are, people will always think y'all shooting false air guns. Now if you got real bullets in your gun, and y'all shooting with some fire, then we'll go out and dominate anybody who's in the next couple weeks. Y'all understand what I'm coming from?
Yes, sir.
You could be the Indian that let somebody take something from you because everybody telling you what they think. You could be Lewis and Clark. You can go fake people out and take some. Or you could be Highland Springs. You just go work for what you get and dominate everybody you play. You got one of the three options.